In my last video, I unpacked a method for determining the optimal die opening for sheet metal air forming given material thickness, inside radius, and bending. This took a little bit of trig and math to derive the equations, but now we can get into some applications. That being said, this video will be covering how to create some useful tools in Excel to put those methods to use. First, I'll show you how to create a die opening selection matrix so press break operators, programmers, or really anyone can easily look up the correct die size from a standardized list. Then I'll show you how to make a simple calculator to select the best die opening for bends at those odd angles where the angle is not 90 degrees. So in the last video, we derived two equations. We'll be using both in this video, so if you haven't seen that last video and want to see how we arrived at these two equations that we'll be using, be sure to go back and check that video out. I'll put a link in the description, but anyways, let's dive in. So first, let's make the die size selection matrix for 90 degree bends. So this matrix will be for 90 degree bends only, which should capture the majority of bends. Most companies are typically bending 90 degrees. Anything aside from that is usually kind of a special case or an oddball scenario. Again, the goal of this is to give break press operators, programmers, or engineers, whoever, a tool to easily look up the correct die size from a standardized list. So the two variables we will need to determine the die size here are the inside radius and the material thickness. So that's what I have going across the top here, inside radius values. These are the kind of common typical values that my company sees. Basically, they just correspond to the punch sizes that we have available. And then the material thickness, these are the common sheet metal gauge thicknesses that we use at my company as well. So you can see right away this does require a little bit of standardization. You will have to kind of have an understanding of what are the common inside radiuses that your company sees or uses, and then also what material thicknesses your company uses as well. I also have a row here for millimeters, so if you work in both units or maybe you only work in millimeters, you can set up a little convert here. So we'll convert the inch value from inches, and then we'll make sure to lock this so we can fill it to millimeters. I know it's kind of cluttered. I'll go back and show you what's going on here with the equation in a sec. Just make sure to lock this again. Okay, so you can see we're converting this inch value from inches to millimeters. That's how the convert function works. We'll fill that over, and then this will be the millimeter values for our inside radius. So then we'll do the same thing here quick. Convert this number from inches, lock it, to millimeters, lock it. And then we'll fill that down without formatting so we don't lose the nice banded columns. Without formatting, there we go. And then this is the millimeter value of our sheet metal thickness. So once you have the values filled in for the available inside radiuses and the available material thicknesses that your company uses, we can set up the equation within our matrix. And this is the equation that we derived in the last video. So the V size equals the square root of 8 times the inside radius plus thickness squared. So all we have to do here is just enter in equals square root of the, 8 times the inside radius, so that value, plus the material thickness, should be there, an extra character in there, that value squared, and that should do it. Yeah, looks like I was missing a parenthesis. So let's go back and lock some things here so we can just quick fill this. We want to lock the row but not the column that this cell is in. So let's do that. Just hit F4 until the row is locked but the column is not. And then with this one, the value over here, the cell over here, we want to lock the column but not the row. So let's do that. There we go. Column, not the row. So once we have that, we can fill this over and then fill this down. Formatting. So now we already have a matrix that tells us the optimal die size given any combination of inside radius and thickness. So let's say for a radius of 120 thousandths of an inch, and maybe for 058 material, so the optimal V size would be 0.502 inches. And this is very cool and everything, but I like to take this a step further because this is only listing out the optimal die size. Chances are, for example, we don't have a die size that's exactly 0.694 inches wide. So what we can do is actually create another table off to the side for us to actually look up what die size we want this value to round to. So again, this will require a little bit of standardization. You'll have to know what die sizes your company has available. And this was the die list that I used to create that. So here are, in inches, the die openings that my company has available. There are just a few of them anyways. So once we have this list, then we can set some ranges where if these values fall between the min and max, then it will select the corresponding die size. So if we add a min column and a max column, so the first one will be between 0 and, just to make this easy, I'm going to go ahead and make the max for each die size halfway in between that die size and the next size up. So that'll be equal to that die size plus the difference of the next size up and that die size divided by 2. So that means that if any one of these values falls between 0 and 0.315 inches, then it will round to this die size. So let's fill this down. And then what we'll do here for the min, it'll be equal to the max of the row above it. And fill this down. And this one will make 2 inches, let's say. Or let's go 2.25. That'll be a little bit more realistic. So again, we're setting the ranges that if one of these values falls between each one of these, it'll select the corresponding die size. And then once we have that set up, we can set up a VLOOKUP to say if that value falls between our table right here, and make sure to lock our table so when we fill up this doesn't move. Column index, we want to look up the third column, which contains our die sizes. Oops. And then we want to set this to true. True means that it's looking up a range. So if this value, the lookup value, falls between a given row and the next row, it'll select this row. So that's exactly what we want. If this value falls between 0 and 0.315, it will select this value here. So we'll close that up and hit enter. We can see it worked perfectly for that first column, or that first cell. So we'll fill that over and fill that down to populate the rest of our matrix. And now our matrix is full of the actual die sizes that our company has available. So it doesn't leave any question as to what die to select. It's telling you exactly what die size to pick. Now, realistically, you probably want to put a little bit more thought into the mins and maxes for your die list. You want to consider things like what dies do we prefer to use, what are our standard sizes, that type of thing, and then also make sure to think about safety included in this. So if the optimal die size says 0.315, if we're going way smaller than that, it might become a safety issue. So you might want to put your max and a little bit closer to the selected die size just for safety reasons. All right, now let's look at how to create a calculator that will determine the optimal die size and then again the suggested die size based on the list, or this min-max die list that we created before as well. So this calculator will use the second equation right here to determine the optimal die size, because in this calculator we're going to consider the angle of the bend as well. So to calculate the optimal V size or die size, we'll just enter in this formula into the cell. It's going to be 4 times the sine of, now we have to use radians in Excel. So it's going to be this angle divided by 2 times the radius, that is times multiplier in there, times the radius plus the thickness, and then all of this over the tangent of the of half the angle. So tan radians, close all that up, and then that's the optimal die size. And then again, for the suggested die size, we're just going to do that VLOOKUP again. Look up this optimal die size value. The table array will be right here. The column index will be 3. And then we'll use true for the approximate match. Enter there. So now we can see that the optimal die size gets bumped down to the available die size that we have of 0.63. So if the angle gets steeper, and remember this is the included angle, so this is the inside of the bend. So a 45 degree angle is actually being bent past 90 degrees, so it's an acute bend. So you can see that the suggested die size or the optimal die size both get bigger because there'll be more material inside the die requiring a larger V. So this can be used to solve basically any bend and calculate the suggested die size based on what dies your company has available. So hopefully this video was useful to anyone who is dealing with die selection in their work. I use both of these tools demonstrated in this video with great results at my company. Let me know your thoughts and if you plan on adding these to your engineering toolbox. And if you use another method, I'd love to hear how you select die sizes at your company. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any of the content that I try to release every week. I cover topics like Excel for engineers, engineering software, data analysis, and recently started SOLIDWORKS tutorials. And if there's anything in particular that you'd like to see, let me know and I'd be happy to cover it in a video. Thanks to all my subscribers and viewers for tuning in. See you next time.